Welcome to fourth module, bending stresses in beams. Bending stresses in beams is what? If a member is subjected to equal and opposite couples, equal and opposite couples means a beam is in a horizontal member. Equal and opposite couple means a rotational equations are going to. This is a moment and this is a moment. We call this as a moment couple because it is rotating. It is rotating. So, moment couple equal and opposite directions. Acting in the same longitudinal plane. Acting in the same longitudinal plane means on the horizontal member. The member is said to be in a pure bending. A member is said to be in a pure bending. If a constant bending moment without shear force, means no shear force, acts on a some length of a beam, the stresses set up on any cross section on the part of the beam constitute a pure couple, the magnitude of which is equal to the bending moment. The internal stresses developed in the beam are known as flexural or bending stress. So, whatever the internal stresses will be developed, that are known as flexural stress or bending stress, which we will be seeing in the further video. The following theory is applicable to the beams subjected to simple or pure bending. When the cross section is not subjected to shear force, since that will cause a distortion of the transverse place. Distortion of a transverse place means if a beam is there, if we are applying a shear force, it will be having a cut at this point. So this cut is known as distortion. In pure bending, there is only bending, no shearing force. This part will not act, only bending will be acting. The assumptions being made are as under. First one, the material is homogeneous, isotropic, that is, it has same values of Young's modulus in tension and compression. What do you mean by isotropic? That is, the Young's modulus values will be having both in same in tension test, also under in compression test. Transverse planes remain plane and perpendicular to the neutral surface after bending. Means if we consider a beam this way, this particular beam, in this beam we are having a small element called as the neutral axis, which is the central part where zero stresses are acting. After a total bending of a member, this line will also have a bending, but where there is no change, means transverse planes remain plane and perpendicular to the neutral surface after bending. These are the transverse planes. This is what the particular plane. This section, if we take after bending, the member remains as the bended part itself only this way. This is perpendicularity will be maintained between the neutral axis and the transverse section. Initially, the beam is straight and all longitudinal filaments are bent into circular arcs with a common center of curvature, which is large compared to the dimensions of cross section. Then fourth assumption, the beam is symmetrical about a vertical longitudinal plane passing through vertical axis of symmetry for horizontal beams. Fifth, the stress is purely longitudinal and the stress concentration effects near the concentrated loads are neglected. Near the concentrated loads means where the particular point load is acting here, this part the stress is neglected. Pure bending. So this is the pure bending, how it is going to act. We are having a pure bending equation. So this is most important. Maximum times it is asked in the finale exams for that reasons. So it is having the importance in with three stunts. Consider a length of a beam under the action of bending moment M as shown in the figure. So this is the particular beam section where we are going to consider this into a bending moment with M. And N is the original length considered of the beam. So this point to this point, whatever the length is there, N is the considered original length of the beam. How much we are considering for a particular section. The neutral surface is plane through XX. This is the neutral surface which is plane through XX. In the side view, when we are going to see it from this direction, the neutral axis NA indicates neutral axis and O is the center of curvature on bending. This is the O is the center of curvature on bending. So this part we can consider. Okay. Now see, when bending is occurring. So when bending is occurring in this way, clear? This fibers will have tension. And whereas these fibers will come inside, for that reason these will have compression. So that is mentioned as compression in the top and tension in the bottom for beams. Clear? So let R is equal to radius of curvature of the neutral surface. So this is the O point when we are taking and neutral axis. This is radius of curvature of the neutral surface. Which is the neutral surface? Neutral surface is XX. So that is R. That is R we are going to consider. Theta, angle subtended by the beam, length at a center O. So this is the angle subtended by the beam. Sigma. Sigma is stress. That is in the longitudinal direction. Stress in the longitudinal direction. A filament of a original length NN at a distance Y. So this part is the distance of this Y. This is what the Y we are considering. This is at a distance of Y. So this part we are considering here. Okay, so this is our neutral axis and this is the NN line. Now, distance Y from will be elongated to length AB. Now, it was a straight. When it is bended, it is elongated to called as A and B. Clear? So, going further, strain in AB. What is the strain in AB? AB. So, what is the strain in AB we have to measure? Equals to AB minus original length. This is the change in length minus original length divided by original length. AB minus NN divided by NN. So, original length of the filament AB is NN. So, or we can write it in this part. What is strain equals to? Stress upon elongation. That is, we have stress is equals to what the particular thing. Strain is equals to stress upon elongation module, or we know E is equals to stress upon strain. Clear? So we are writing this format into changed format as strain is equals to stress upon elongation. So we will write stress upon elongation. So now what is stress? R plus Y into R theta minus R theta. This is the original part. This is again original part, the change. So that we are writing. AB is what? AB is R plus Y into theta minus NN is what? R into theta. NN is again what? R into theta. So what all are going to get cancelled? R is going to get cancelled here. Minus R plus R will get theta, theta will get, theta gets cancelled, taking, so remaining is what? Y upon R. Or we can say sigma upon Y is equals to E upon R. Sigma upon Y or E upon R. Also we can write sigma as Y into E divided by R, which is proportional to Y. as ER can be taken as a constant. As this part, we can take it as the constant part. Now, delta A. Delta A is what? Delta A is this part, the area. Delta A, be an element of cross-sectional area of a transverse plane at a distance y from the neutral axis NA. For pure bending, net normal force on the cross-section is equal to 0, or integration of stress into delta A, that is dA, equal to 0, or integration of stress is what, E upon R into y, we are considering that, then d upon dA is equal to 0, or E upon R integration, as this is constant, we are taking it out, integration of y with respect to dA is equal to 0, or integration of y into dA is equal to 0. Let us consider this as one equation, the earlier sigma upon y into is equal to E by R as one equation. This indicates the condition that the neutral axis passes through the centroid of the section. Okay. Also, bending moment is equals to moment of a normal force about neutral axis. So now, moment equation we have to write. Moment equals to integration of sigma into dA into y is equals to this part, integration E upon R into y dA into y. ER as a constant, integration y into y, y square into dA. Then when we are considering this, integration of y square will become as I. Moment of inertia, that with respect to length, then is equals to E upon I divided by R, where, see here, where I is equals to integration of y square into dA, as we know it from our first year mechanics also, that with respect to y, integration with respect to dA, y square integration is known as moment of inertia. So, moment of inertia or second moment of area of the section. So, from equation 1, 2 and 3, we write one more equation, that is sigma by y is equals to m by I is equals to E by R. So, how we are writing this all things? Sigma by y is equals to E by R is already known to us, and m is equals to E by R what we are writing. So when we are equating these all equations, sigma by y is equals to, here I will come in the denominator for this, m by I is equals to E by R, or also we can write sigma by y is equals to m by I, m by I it is, sorry, or m by I is equals to E by R, or we can write sigma by y is equals to E by R. So this is the bending equation as pure bending equation. Please remember this, pure bending equation. Section modulus. Some definitions. The ratio of moment of inertia divided by y, where y is the farthest or the most distance point of the section from the neutral axis, is called as section modulus, that is denoted by the z. Z equals to moment of inertia of a neutral axis divided by distance of a farthest from neutral axis. So, that we are going to consider, that is z is equals to I divided by y, what we have to remember, this part. Thus, moment of inertia, moment is equals to sigma into I by y we are considering, which is equals to sigma into z, that is this part. Okay, so moment is equals to sigma into I by y, which we are taking I by y, we know it as section modulus z. So moment will be equals to stress multiplied by section modulus. Now one more definition, moment of resistance, the maximum bending moment which can be carried by a given section for a given maximum value of stress is known as the moment of resistance MR, is known as moment of resistance MR. Clear? Then comes moment of inertias. So here I'll also take some moment of inertias which can be easily understood. Moment of inertia of a rigid body is obtained by summing up the products of various particles with the square of their distances from a given axis. Parallel axis there. The moment of inertia about any axis parallel to the centroidal axis is equal to the moment of inertia through the centroidal axis plus the product of the area of the figure and the square of the distance between the two axes. Moment of inertia is axis parallel to centroidal axis. This part. Okay. And parallel to this axis, such as this one. Moment of through the centroidal plus the product of the area of the figure. Product of the figure area is this part. And square of the distance between two axes. Square of the distance between two axes. We are squaring this distance. Rectangle. Consider an elementary strip of dA delta y. Thickness at a distance y. Here we can see the moment of inertia. The moment of inertia about centroidal axis xx, about this axis. Okay. Ixx is equals to integration, below this is minus d by 2, above this is plus d by 2. Okay, so integration from minus d by 2 to plus d by 2, y square into b into d into y. B into d into y is what? Y square is the particular squaring of the distance. Then area of this b into d, b into d into this y. That is the particular distance. Therefore, is equals to B is constant. We are not taking B because it is not varying with respect to B. It is varying with respect to D. Depth it is varying. Y square dy is equals to B. So B into y cube divided by 3 d by 2 and d by 2 minus d by 2. This dy is nothing but this part, differential. We can write this as dy also. Please take it into account. Then y cube by 3. This is the integration, y square integration. Y n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So plus minus d by 2 plus d by 2 when we substitute, we get this as bd cube by 12. If I take it as a parallel axis theorem, IAB is equals to IXX plus AX square, which is equals to BD cube by 12 plus BD into D by 2 whole square is equals to BD cube by 3. It is IAB, moment of inertia about this section. Okay, not about middle section, about bottom section, BD cube by 3. Then section modulus Z, IXX upon Y max, IXX upon Y max. That is BD cube by 12 divided by D by 2, which is equals to BD square by 6. BD square by 6. Similarly, other figures are also hollow rectangle about centroidal axis XX. IXX is equals to B capital BD cube minus small BD cube by 12, which is capital. The external part is capital, the internal part is smaller. So this part is all one into hollow section. This is hollow section. Z section modulus, that is BD cube minus BD cube by 12 divided by D by 2. That is BD cube minus BD cube divided by 6 times D. Then comes I section. So here we can see for I section also about X axis. It remains similar for symmetrical I section. Okay, this is a symmetrical I section. B is same, D is same, small b we are taking. Small b is what? This distance they have deducted from total b. Then this will become as b by 2, b by 2. So here we can see where b is b minus where thickness of d is equals to d minus 2 times thickness of flange. So this is called as flange, this is called as web, this is called as flange. Okay, hope you have understood. Even for the C section, it takes the similar section. So ZX, the section modulus, BD cube minus BD cube divided by 6 times. Rectangular section, about centroidal axis XX, X, IXX is equal to BD cube by 36 and about the base. Here we know, here triangular section at BD cube by 36. At AB we get as BD cube by 12. At bottom BD cube by 12 for triangular. At middle BD cube by 36. Circular section about centroidal axis. ID raised to 4 by 64. ZX I XX divided by Y maximum. That is ID cube by 32. Because ID raised to 4 by 64 divided by D by 2 it is. So that is pi d cube by 32. Hollow circular section. This is xx pi into d raised to 4 minus d raised to 4 by 64. Zx is equals to pi by 2, pi by 32, d raised to 4 minus d raised to 4 by d. Thank you. See you in the next video.